Hello. Oh, Echo. Welcome to your Zoom class. Does anybody know what we will be discussing today?
I have no idea.
Okay, great. Well, this is a new series that I'm starting on my channel called Your Website Shows. I'm a web developer, and I think that most websites suck. Does that mean your own websites suck? Yes, and actually, that was going to be the topic of today's video, but then I came across this article. Modifications to CCPA regulations prohibit dark patterns. Dark patterns sound scary. They're not scary, but they are manipulative, and they suck, and I hate them. So let's use these new regulations as a jumping point for further discussion. Here, I made a PowerPoint presentation for you. So basically, what's happening right now is that the California Consumer Privacy Act just made some adjustments banning dark patterns. This is a good thing for an overall better user experience. Dark patterns aren't necessarily new. They've been categorized as dark patterns by Harry Brignall since 2010. You've probably seen them time and time again. So what are they? Dark design patterns are manipulation tactics. The article that I referred to before describes them as deliberate attempts to subvert or impair a consumer's choice to opt out. Dark patterns may be used to obfuscate the opt-out request process or deceive the consumer into granting knowing consent. As far as I know, the CCPA updates are specifically placing the ban on data collection opt-outs, but for this presentation, I also want to take a look at the general website dark patterns that are used to sell services or otherwise keep people hooked, because I hate it and I want to complain about it. The too long didn't read that they give us on the new regulation bans. Using an opt-out request process that requires more steps than the process for a consumer to opt back into the sale of personal information after previously opting out. We like to call this obstruction, or the roach motel dark pattern. Have you ever moved in with roaches? I can tell you from experience with my last apartment, it's super easy to get into the situation and then much more difficult to change your mind and leave. You've probably seen this pop-up before, or something similar, asking you to select what information you're comfortable giving up. This specific example is from The Telegraph. Here, I have the Privacy Manager pop-up. First of all, pop-ups are annoying website features in general. I'm not sure if I've already unchecked everything during a previous visit, but yeah, everything is off until you go to the Legitimate Interests section. What does this even mean? We have a need to use your data for this processing purpose that is required for us to deliver services to you. What? Am I dumb? This is the epitome of dark patterns examples. All of the settings are the same as in the User Consent tab, so I can only imagine that this means that they will still collect and sell your data to vendors if they feel like it. And you have to uncheck them one by one. Notice how there's an accept all button, but no reject all button. I hate this so much. That's exactly what this regulation is for. The action to opt out takes much longer than it takes to opt in. If I unchecked all of this and then accidentally clicked accept all because I thought it was the save and exit button, I would have to waste more time unchecking everything again. But I don't even think that I would be able to, because after you save your changes, the Privacy Manager just disappears. I can't find it again. Also, just look at how many vendors there are. Oh my god. Extending this dark pattern outside of data collection, I'd like to introduce you to a website called Just Delete Me. It tells you how to delete your accounts. You can also use it to filter websites by how difficult it is to delete your account, like hard or literally impossible. If you want to know how to improve user experience on your website, just be transparent and explicit. Don't make it difficult for them to make their own decisions. It takes like 3 seconds to sign up with Airbnb, especially if you sign up with another service. But then to delete your account, you have to contact customer support, which could take another few days. And then, not even all of your data will be deleted. That's ridiculous and a little unfair. And here's another example. It takes 4 steps for someone to cancel their CBS subscription. First, they tried to bribe you with a discount, but then you say no thanks and have to re-enter your password. They give you a confirmation page with a checkbox stating that you understand the terms of cancellation, and then they make their primary button, no, don't cancel. So you have to click the hidden yes, cancel my subscription text underneath. And then they force you to answer a survey of why you decided to cancel. You can't even cancel your account if you don't give them a reason, even though you just told them 3 times that you would like to cancel your account. Other, your website sucks. The next CCPA ban is on using confusing language like double negatives. For example, don't not sell my personal information. There are so many examples of this being used in the wild, it's not even funny at this point. It's one of the cheapest tricks in the book of website ethics, yet companies are still doing this. We call this dark pattern trick questions, and you've probably seen them before. Here's one where pretty much every other checkbox is, if you would prefer not to hear from us, tick here, as opposed to, if you would like these offers, tick here. It's horrible. Here's another example from EA, where checking the checkbox disables targeted advertising and data collection. This is so frustrating. Like, imagine going to the doctor's office, and they make you fill out paperwork that says, check the relevant boxes if you do not have the following symptoms. You want me to check all of the symptoms that I don't have? It feels like it defeats the purpose of a checkbox. Oh wait, That's exactly what it does.
Want to improve your website UX?
Make it make sense.
Thank you for coming to my TED Talk.
Epic Games is guilty of this as well. Click here to not receive emails.
It's so backwards
because you're missing out on users who actually want to receive emails from you.
I actually spent a lot of time this past summer unsubscribing from as many email lists as I could,
and I came across this one a lot.
The button says save preferences, but the tiny text says that clicking the button resubscribes you.
So it's really not clear to the user that they have already saved their preferences when they unsubscribed, and they will most likely resubscribe.
It's just textbook website manipulation,
and it really tells me that you do not care about your users.
Here is a membership status with confusing button actions.
If you click on cancel, do you cancel your membership, or do you cancel the action of canceling your membership?
If you click on continue, do you continue the process of canceling, or do you continue your membership?
I want to throw your website in the garbage.
On this example from Virgin Media, the label says keeping in touch, so the user assumes that you want to keep in touch if you tick the box.
But ticking the box means that they won't not only contact you, but also share your information with other areas of their company,
which is not at all what keeping in touch means.
Here's another one where every other checkbox gives you opposite instructions.
Tick the relevant box if you do not wish to receive information, followed by would you like sale emails?
And to put the cherry on top,
your personal information will not be shared with other companies for their marketing purposes.
But then a couple of paragraphs later, they say we may also disclose your information to third parties who may contact you with details of other products.
Email us to opt out.
I'm done.
Requiring consumers to click through or listen to unnecessary reasons why they should not submit a request to opt out before confirming their request.
I would categorize this as an extensive version of the confirm shaming dark pattern.
The mild version would be like this example, where if they decline, the implication is, nah, journalists should go hungry.
No one thinks that journalists should go hungry.
I just don't want to pay for your service, which you are probably getting dollars to the penny of your journalists.
Okay, back to the regulation, and bear with me for this analogy, but if you've never had to get an abortion before.
Okay, there's this episode of BoJack Horseman
that kind of highlights the same shaming tactic.
I don't think that I can legally share the clip here, but basically Diane and Mr. Peanut Butter go to the abortion clinic and the doctor goes, okay, before the procedure you have to have an ultrasound, listen to the heartbeat. At 1 month your puppy has a favorite color and it's probably blue.
And you'll also have to watch 20 hours of puppy videos.
It's to shame women into not getting an abortion.
And for websites, it's to shame people into buying your subscription.
A couple years ago, I downgraded from the paid version of Dropbox to the basic free version.
And I remember being so frustrated that they did the exact same thing.
I found that someone else had recorded the video of his experience, so let's go through this together.
So I've hit the cancel trial button, and scrolling down here, big blue button, no, let's take me down to Dropbox. Okay, space, definitely don't want to cancel, more and more information. Oh, okay, maybe it's one of these blue buttons. Oh no, I still want to downgrade. 3 out of 4 of these are about not canceling. And I still can't cancel. Well, they'd like to know why. Okay, so I don't know. I only needed it temporarily. Here again, dark pattern. Let's hit continue. Okay, I still can't cancel. I'm gonna see the same stuff that I just saw. Yes, I still want to downgrade. And done.
I hate websites. Facebook also does this. When I deactivated my account several times, because somehow they always get me to reactivate my account for a completely different service, there's always a, your friends will miss you page with pictures of my friends and a required reason for leaving. I think I will need to make a dedicated video about why Facebook sucks in the future.
You're so guilty of dark patterns that there's even one named after the founder.
Privacy Zuckering. But back to CCPA regulations.
The next one we have is requiring a consumer to provide personal information that is unnecessary to implement an opt-out request.
With the Just Delete Me examples, we have things like answering survey questions before you can submit your request, or providing personal identification, or sending your IP address and your internet service provider information to League of Legends before closing your account.
I didn't really have much to touch on here,
aside from just make it as easy to stop being perceived by large companies as it is to start being perceived.
Website do's and don'ts. Do, be honest. Don't, be greedy.
The last ban that we have in this too long didn't read. Upon clicking the Do Not Sell My Personal Information link, requiring a consumer to search or scroll through the text of a website or privacy policy to submit the opt-out request.
I might categorize this one as misdirection, but let me know if it should be categorized as something else.
Imagine this, you just clicked opt-out on a website somewhere, and it takes you to a giant page of terms of service and privacy and a wall of text, a novel, if you will. Where do you go to opt-out? Just scroll a little bit. Scroll a little bit more, and there's a little paragraph with a teeny standard checkbox for you to opt out. It's like a game of Where's Waldo, except a lot less colorful, a lot more corporate,
and your personal data will be sold to marketing companies if you give up. So yeah, these are just a few examples of how dark patterns trick you online. If you've experienced any of these, which I'm sure you have, let me know about them in the comments. The best thing you can do to fight dark patterns is calling them out by name. And let me know if I missed anything. California is making great progress with these regulations, and I saw a comment that said that Brazil's consumer defense law is pretty advanced as well. I'm really glad that we're starting to see bans like this so that we can keep everyday consumers safe and making the decisions that they actually want to make. As always, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed. I'll see you Wednesday on Twitch and next Monday for another new video. Until then, just remember that you're worth fighting.